Today in the shop, we're gonna get somebody new working with a pump that they have not worked before. So we're gonna walk them through it.
I'm going to take it apart now and see if there's anything we can do to repair it. Oh. I think that's not supposed to look like that. It goes back and forth on it. Like it hits it back and forth like that. And it looks like it wore right into it. So that's from the heat. So this sits like this in there, and this pushes it like that. And that looks like a lot of heat built up and started wearing right into this.
That's not supposed to look like that, is it?
I don't think so. That's a servo piston of some sort, right?
Yeah, it's off of PAVC 65. If the Swash plate's digging into that, that's probably no good either, right?
How is it?
Maybe it's still okay. That's definitely needs to be changed.
What is that? This one too.
Multiple pulsation, multiple on and off.
Yeah, learn something new every day. It looked pretty new, so it's got a little weird mark. Oh, it's got a ding on there. A little ding. It's like something hit it. That'll have to be replaced. Everything else in here is pretty clean. I'm probably gonna get Mark to kind of go through it again with me.
So to start with, we checked with the barrel. Some scratches, but it should lap out. There's no damage to the outer ring. And it's nice on the inside where the pistons run. Some cavitation, aeration damage. Either you have a leak in your suction line that'll cause aeration, or cavitation is just struggling to pull oil. Pumps don't want to pull oil, they only want to push it. As far as this is concerned, you can see it's got a huge groove in it, but it's not even centered. That has caused just a minor bit of wear. We can probably repair that without too much trouble. That's on the Swash plate itself. Now the issue is when you see that, it's going to cause wear on the main housing, which is behind you. So if you look inside, there's a brass sleeve. And if you feel the brass sleeve, you can't really see it, but there's a lip, so it kind of goes up and then you can feel the wear. If there's any more than about 2 thou clearance in here between that servo piston and this guy, the pump will be unstable because it's getting too much leakage past the piston itself. The other thing you check is your wear band. This looks good. We'll pull the shaft and see, but frankly, because this is wore, the whole housing's no good. The cost of replacing this and making it perfect dead on with the right clearance will cost us as much as replacing the housing new. One is going to gain control, and then another one will take over, and it's going to push it out of the way, and this is just going to constantly go like this as each pump struggles for control. And the way to get around that is to offset your differentials, about 15, 20 PSI each, and that will minimize that hunting, if not eliminate it. Galling takes up clearance, but what builds up on the outside also leaves clearance on the insides.
Yeah, I didn't know any of that, so that's why I went.
We make this for you. So if you like it, subscribe, and we'll keep making them.
Yeah, so now I'm gonna write up everything that's wrong with it, and then somebody else will speak to the Piston.